Thank you so much for joining me in my channel. I appreciate each and every one of you. Now let's get into it. Today's topic is going to be about how to deal with depression and anxiety. When I was in Nigeria, before I came here, my grandmother had a stroke. Mind you, I was 14. And that was such a hard moment for me. And I would have gone into depression or anxiety, but I didn't. And, you know, the tips that I'm about to give to you guys truly helped me overcome that phase of my life, because unfortunately my grandmother is still having stroke. Every day I pray for her, and I pray that you guys will join me and pray for my grandmother. She's still battling with stroke, and it's not, I love her so much, it's not easy, and it's something dear to my heart. So anyway, I mean, sometimes when I think about it, it breaks my heart. Like, she's such a strong woman, and she does not deserve to go through stroke since I was 14, guys. Like, I'm 28 now, so I don't understand why, such a thing will happen. But you know what? There's a reason for everything. So I'm not here to be negative, and I'm not here to even, like, entertain this. Rather, I want to be positive and put a light to this. So that's why I'm here, to let you know that you're not alone. You're not alone. You can deal with it. Depression is not something that you should just suffer within yourself. So there are tips and ways that you can overcome it. So let's just get right into it, right? Number one tip is get into a routine. When I mean get into a routine, when you feel like you're depressed, you can shut down and you can feel like, oh my God, the world has come to an end. This is a time for you to get into a routine and just take it one step at a time. One day melts into the next, meaning you can just take it one step at a time. You don't have to do everything all at once. Just, even if it's a routine of washing dishes, just do it. Just something simple. Get into a routine of getting up in the morning and just going to the kitchen to wash dishes. Things like that can get your mind away from being in bed all day and feeling anxiety or depressed. Number two, the second point, set goals for yourself. When you set goals for yourself, start small. Don't start big. For example, you set goal to run a marathon. I'm not saying you should start now to run a marathon. Rather, you can take a walk. Just each day, take it small by small and take a walk, you know? Get out of the house and take small walks and come back. It helps. It's so huge. And these things, I'm telling you guys, helped me so much, because I did not sit around to mull over my grandmother having a stroke. I did not sit around to mull over and just be like, you know, feel bad or just feel like, God, why? Just have a routine, set goals for yourself, small goals, and just see, watch what, and it helps a lot to set small goals for yourself. Number three, you have to exercise. Guys, don't sit around just, you know, like I said over and over again. Exercising is something that mentally and physically, emotionally as well, helps you get rid of so many things. So exercise is a key. And when I mean exercise, you, like I said before, take walks, take little step by step, just maybe even going to the grocery store, or you know, depending on where, how distant the grocery store is from your house, you know, little things like that. Get out the house. Don't be in a house all squared and boxed up and just feeling all alone. Loneliness is horrible, and loneliness leads to depression and anxiety. So if you don't get out the house, it's going to be very hard for you. So I encourage you to get out the house and exercise. Don't start by setting up goals or doing marathon. Take small walks. So hopefully that helps. Number four, eating healthy. Guys, I encourage you to eat healthy. Please do me a favor. Do not indulge yourself in eating ice cream all the time or having apple pie with an amazing crust and you're just eating and eating and eating. If that's you, stop. Put a stop to that and eat healthy vegetables, salads, you know, just little by little. I know it's not easy, but you can overcome this. Let me give you a Bible passage. It's so funny when I wanted to talk about this, it's like the Holy Spirit just ministered to me. 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 29. For thou art my lamp, O Lord, and the Lord will lighten my darkness. Samuel was saying that, God, you are the lamp to my darkness. You are the light to my darkness. So let God be the light to your darkness. Depression and anxiety is darkness. That's the plan of the enemy over your life, and you don't want that, guys. So I pray that, you know, the Bible is such a way that I rely on the Word of God to just show me what to do when I'm feeling down or, you know, little things like this. So everything is here. The answers are in this book. I'm telling you, just type it in. What passage can help me overcome this issue? And trust me, the Holy Spirit will minister that to you. The last one, guys, is get enough sleep. Try to stay away from social media. I've said that so many times. TV, computer, phones, turn it off and get sleep. You know, sometimes when you're like going through something and your mind is so clouded, sometimes you need to just shut it down and go to sleep. Don't take naps. Just rest. It's good to just rest in God and just say, God, this issue, depression and anxiety, or whatever this situation that I'm going through, God, I'm just going to hand it over to you. And I'm going to pray that you are the light in this darkness. And I'm praying that you will just remove this darkness from me right now. And God, I just give this burden to you. And just go to sleep. Shut your phone. Turn it off and just sleep. And trust me, when you wake up, you feel so refreshed and rejuvenated. And I mean, it's not going to just wipe away immediately. Give it some time. It's going to work. These are little things that I feel like can help you overcome depression and anxiety. And I hope that you guys will take at least one of these tips that I'm giving you, not likely, take it to heart. And think about it and at least do one of them, even if it's not two or three or four or five, at least do one and just see where it takes you. And also don't forget to rely in the Word of God. Don't ever forget to call on Him when you're going through depression or anxiety or any other things that the Word want to put out there and call a name. I hope all these tips are helpful. I hope and I pray that if you are going through this and if you are struggling with these issues, I am praying for you. And leave your comment below and let me know how you have overcome depression and anxiety, whether it's when you lost a loved one or when you lost your job. You know, these are things that people go through that make them go immediately into depression and anxiety. But you should not be captive over that. Be free. I declare freedom in each and every one of you. And I pray that God will continue to heal you and God will continue to take you to the next level of your life and of your purpose. So stay blessed and stay encouraged, guys. You are made to be beautiful and you are made to accomplish all the good things that God has planned for you. So stay blessed and God bless you all. If you have not subscribed to my channel and you like what you're seeing and you like being in my channel, please just subscribe, share this video to all your friends, and give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to turn in your bell buttons to know when I do my videos. But anyway, like it, share it, comment, all that jazz, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys, and until then, stay beautiful and stay inspired. God bless.